A little chilly out this morning. Don't know about your gyro, but I know I move a little bit slower when it's cold. So if you're seeing your gyro, and it could be your attitude gyro or your DG, and moving a little bit slow in the airplane, I don't blame it. It's a little bit chilly. I'm Bruce Grambin with Midcontinent Instruments and Avionics. I am the specialist for technical support. And, you know, maybe we can go in where it's a little bit warmer and take a look and check it out and see how they can take care of you in there. We're back in the warmth from being out in the cold. So let's take a look and see what these guys are going to do with these gyros once they come to us after they failed in cold weather. What happens is on gyros, when it gets cold, they start having issues, and that is due to the bearings. Bearings in these gyros, after a while, your oil starts to become grease. And when that happens, then it gets cold, they just don't want to come up to speed. So you go out and start up your aircraft, or you're flying, and it temperature drops, or it's really cold, all of a sudden you start seeing your gyro starts precessing. If you have a gyro that is precessing, what you might see is in the air, you're going to see a gyro precess over, and it may just be 2 or 3 degrees, or you may have it pitched down. On a DG, pretty much what they start to do is roll. And they can actually tumble after a while if they fall over too far. You got to remember, on most gyros inside there, and when they're running on the rotor, it's kind of like a top. And so, you know, you can spin it, and it spins really fast, and it stays up. As it starts slowing down, it starts to fall over. Gyro is kind of the same principle. They run at a certain RPM. So when that RPM starts to get less, the gyro won't stay up to speed, and it starts to drop off, which then causes your precess. So if you start to see the gyro starting to roll over, or your attitude portion starting to tumble down, or your DG starting to precess, starting to spin, anything like that, it's probably a good chance, time for it to be sent in for us to take a look at it. We have a wide range of abilities to do a little bit of everything, but we really specialize in the 256. You know, we've been doing these since these things first existed. We have technicians here with years and years of experience. I mean, we're talking 30, 40 years combined. It's even more than that, but these guys know what they're doing. And when these guys do a gyro, we do it right. So we use manufactured parts. The bearings are manufactured from Bendix King bearings. Everything in the gyro we go through, completely tear them down, put it back together, clean, align. You get it back, it's a great gyro. We have everything repainted, everything redone up front. So the ball and all that stuff, is when you get it back, it's gonna look like new, but it's also gonna work like new when you get it back. So if you have any questions, give us a call. But the guys here, and they know their stuff, send the stuff in to us, do a good job.